Today I have booked in myself at a funeral director's at Waters and Sons. My customer wanted a three-course compound paint correction. I like to start on the wheels. I spray iron fallout on the alloys. I like to let the iron fallout dwell for 2 to 3 minutes before applying the snow foam. Once the car is fully covered in snow foam, I like to use a soft brush to get into all the nooks and crannies where my soft mitt won't reach. I repeat this process throughout the car. Once I finish this process, I then spray the car down to get rid of all the suds. And now the car is completely rinsed down from all the suds. It's time to shampoo the car. I use a 2-bucket method, one with just clean water and the other one with the shampoo in it. I use 2 grit guards and a very soft wash mitt. Now the car is completely shampooed and dried off with a soft towel, I like to use my hot air blower to get rid of all the standing water in the nooks and crannies. As you can see, there's still standing water coming out of all the nooks and crannies with my air dryer. Now the vehicle is completely dry, it's time to clay bar the vehicle. This process has to be done before any polishing. I repeat this throughout the vehicle's paintwork. My customer wanted the engine bay gleaming, so I had to go to work and get rid of all the dirt and grime that was sitting in the engine bay. Starting off, I use my jet wash to rinse away any dust and grime. Then I use a snow foam lance to spray onto the engine bay itself, then I use 2 long brushes to agitate the snow foam. Being ambidextrous is pretty good for me because I can use both my hands at the same time. It definitely speeds up the process. Once I finish using the brushes, I then use my jet wash to spray away any snow foam residue. I then use a degreaser to spray all the way around the engine bay to make sure that the whole engine bay is completely coated. Then I use a brush to agitate the degreaser. Once I use degreaser, I like to use a steam cleaner to actually agitate all the grease away. I like to use my steam cleaner to get straight into the middle of the engine bay where my brush couldn't reach. I make sure the engine bay is completely dried with my air dryer, and this is the end result of my hard work. Okay, step one of the paint correction. This is a cutting compound which gets rid of any scratches and marring on the paintwork. The process carries on throughout the vehicle, making sure that all the scratches and marring are completely disappeared. Where this vehicle is so large, I do door panel by door panel so I don't miss any scratches or marring. Okay, come to stage two. This is the polishing compound. So this is refines the paintwork that I cut originally. Using polishing compounds, it brings back the clarity on the paintwork. Because this vehicle is so high, I had to stand on a ladder and stretch out the best of my ability with my buffing tool. As you can see, it was quite tricky. Coming to the internal, my customer wanted me to make the woodwork as glossy as possible. So I used an internal detailer, and the result was pretty good, to be honest. Once I finish cleaning the woodwork, I then get into the interior of the vehicle and start cleaning the leather seats. Made sure the door cards were clean as well. This is definitely the largest window I've ever cleaned on a vehicle. It was a bit awkward climbing through, but I got the job done in the end. Now all the windows have been polished, Now it's time for the spray ceramic waxing. I love using this product because it goes on very well and you can buff it up to a high standard. This is the last bit I need to do on the vehicle. I use Meguiar's tyre gel to apply it on the tyres to make them look glossy. I then use an old rag to buff up the face of the alloy wheels themselves. Now then, this is 9 hours later of my hard work. This paintwork came out absolutely amazing. Once I've finished the interior looks glossy and very presentable. Happy how this vehicle has come out today. The paintwork's a mirror shine as always, and the wheels and tyres look absolutely amazing. Thanks for watching. See you later.